things. First is services are intangible. Now, what does the word intangible mean? That I cannot feel. For services, we can experience. We cannot touch. We cannot see. Or we will not feel also. So that is one important characteristic. Second is, services don't result in the ownership of anything. It means that in buying a McD burger, I don't become the owner of the outlet. Or say if you are students of Pumba, I am not to own it. So once the service for you has been terminated, you own a right to any service. And third is productive, not be tied to any physical. That's pure service. So like I said, I may be talking to you without using any physical product. Or services are produced by some physical product. Tied to some physical product. So is it clear to you? So services are performances. They are intangible. There is no transfer of ownership. And production may or may not be tied to any physical product. So is it understood?
Yes, ma'am.
So how many are there in the presently have joined?
Ma'am, there are about 72 people, but they've muted the audio and so that there's no disturbance in the middle.
Okay, that's good. So now we come to the second slide. Just like products, right? Products have characteristics. So services also, they are made of a bundle of attributes. So bundle of attributes means that when I begin to decode or break down the services, then I will see that, just a minute, my file is not downloading. Just a minute. So what are the components? Can you read out?
Yes, ma'am. The second slide is the Indian scenario.
The Indian scenario and all you will do, that I'm not worried about.
Okay, so where do you want me to go now?
Just why is it mine is not opening? Just a minute.
You can see it on your screen, right? You can see my screen on your screen.
Yeah, but I am speaking very loudly. The headset is very close to me.
Okay.
Okay, service package. So service package has five components. First is the physical infrastructure in which the service is being delivered. Right, and that is called as a supporting facility. So the building in which I am delivering the service becomes the supporting facility. Say Pumba building is a supporting facility. So is it clear? Facility. So every service, if you break down into attributes, this is what is going to come out of it. First thing would be the building, so that we call as a supporting facility. Second thing that will come out is the facilitating goods. Now these are the products that get consumed over time. So can you tell me in a restaurant what gets consumed over time?
Others, the question is open to everyone.
Yeah.
You'll put yourselves and say, give the answer, please.
You can. The food and cuisines.
Yes, very good. So the food gets consumed over time. So that we call, it is a product part of it. Now, so you, when you break down services, you will begin to see that some of the components are absolutely intangible components. Some of them are not services, they are tangible goods. So a service could be a mixture of service elements and product elements. So services are not pure services. Nowadays, you see what you see around is a mixture of the two. So both of them have been added to each other to augment. Say Maruti is known for what? Not as much as the product plus the service also. The best service award by JD Power. So Maruti is known for both. So services these days, because of competition, because of our need to differentiate, need to be competitive. In services, we are adding products, and in products, we are adding services. Most of the services these days will have some or the other tangible component that we call as the facilitating goods. So in a restaurant, like somebody said, that the food is a product that gets consumed over time. Plus you have the menu cards. Those are tangible. You can touch. They get deteriorated over time. You will have to replace, and so on. In a hotel, similarly, what do you see? What gets consumed over time? The bed linen and all that you will have to keep on changing. So that is the second component of a service, which gets consumed. That is called as the good, the tangible part of the service. But this, besides these two, there are other more important things in services. Those are called as absolutely intangible elements. These are called as explicit and implicit service. Now, how do I explain explicit? Explicit services, like you see in the slide, I have shown departure time. So when you are traveling by an airplane, so airline is a service, right? So when we are traveling by airplane, are we able to find out the departure time? Are we able to find out whether the flight took off in time? Is it known to us? The question is open to everybody. So when the flight is taking off, whether it is taking off in time or not, is this component known to us or it is not?
Yes, it is known to us.
Yes, ma'am, it is known to us.
Very good. So it is displayed. So you easily know that, say, Go Air, the flights are not taking off in time. So that is a service, but that particular component can easily be judged by you. Ki ye achha ho raha hai, ki ye kharaab, whether it is a service is performing on that parameter or it is not performing. Such components that I can easily judge, right, are called as explicit components. Those are service components. Those are not product components, but I can easily judge that how a service is performing on that particular attribute. So that's fine. The last part, that is implicit parts, the implicit part of a service is most intangible, right? So here, say, where, say, probably a particular person got admitted in a hospital and he went a kidney transplant, right? So do you exactly know what happened to you inside the operation theater? Or you rely a lot on... No. So often you see that people go for operations, probably a kidney is stolen. So exactly in these kind of services, we exactly are not able to judge how the service was delivered. So trust and credibility factors play a big role. Often we are misdiagnosed. Often we are overdiagnosed. So small kids these days, you see that n number of tests, blood tests, even if they have a fever, they will give us, they will be prescribed a blood test or n number of medicines. But do they ever find out, do the parents ever find out whether it was right or wrong? No. So in these cases, the consumer is depending a lot on the credibility of the doctor or the hospital. So such services, such components are called as implicit components. Those are very important in case of services. So can you talk about some recent cases where credibility was hit in the services sector? Which, very good. So Yes Bank, we saw that people had so much trust, and same story now here about HDFC also. So the whole banking sector is impacted because of one particular bank and its lending policy. So that's Yes Bank, and people just couldn't predict that this would ever happen to them. So safety and security of your money in case of a banking service is which component then? It is an implicit component.
Implicit service. Implicit.
Yes. Say if you go to Chokhidhani, have you gone to Chokhidhani?
Yes.
Yes.
It's a typical Rajasthan village where you get Rajasthani cuisine, you get entertainment that is all a typical Rajasthan village type. So what could be the implicit component there?
The theme of...
You have different rides, that a bullock cart ride or a camel ride. So a theme kind of an entertainment restaurant.
The theme will be the implicit one then?
Which one would be?
The theme or the people serving, the clothes they are wearing and the type of persona they...
But clothes I can see. So why will it be implicit?
Okay.
Whatever I can easily make out. Right, that the clothes are soiled, I will be able to see that the waiter's clothes are soiled. So it will be explicit. Clothes in any case is a product. So that goes into your facilitating good. Clothes will not come as a service comp. Clothes in any, everywhere, wherever you can touch a component, it is tangible, it becomes a product. You will have to market it like a product. So when, again, if you look at services, services are bundles. A particular service is a bundle of attributes. Some attributes are tangible. Certain others are intangible. The tangible attributes like food, like clothes, like linen, like tablecloth, like the cutlery, you will have to market like a product. The intangible ones like safety, kindness, security, all these, the trust, all these are intangible. You will have to market like a service. So now when you look at a service, segregate the tangible and the intangible. Product marketing principles would be applicable to tangible. Service marketing principles would be applicable to the intangible. So essentially how we define services is that those are absolutely intangible components. But in because of competitive situation, today you see most of them are a mix of both of the attributes. So in Chokidhani, what could be the implicit part? Yes.
The authenticity or the ethnicity what they provide.
Yes. Authenticity is so important. It should not happen.
Also the ambience.
Also the ambience, yes. Very good.
Ethnic vibes.
But can't we see the ambience? I mean, we can feel the ambience, we can see the ambience, we can touch the ambience.
The authenticity part is absolutely a explicit, is an implicit service. Why authenticity is a good answer? Because it should not happen that tomorrow a particular tourist is visiting Rajasthan and he feels that a Rajasthan village is very different from what I saw in Chokidhani. So that faith of authenticity should not be hurt. So it should be authentic.
Yeah,
regarding ambience, also the authenticity of the ambience, right? The kind of linen you are using, the decor that you are using, everything there is terracotta, typical Rajasthani village kind of a getup. The kind, they don't use lights, they use oil lamp. The dress that people are wearing would be typical Rajasthani dress. So authenticity of the ambience, right? But as far as lighting is concerned, ventilation is concerned, these would be explicit because you can feel it. You can. So credibility part is implicit, that you can only experience. At times you cannot experience. Only time will tell. So to that extent, it is intangible.
Right? Since we spoke about... ma'am, since we spoke about Yes Bank, just wanted to understand, would we consider Kingfisher Airlines also into the same scenario?
Kingfisher Airlines, yeah, in that sense. But the credibility part is, see, if they have played with the trust of somebody, then the credibility. See, at times it is just an environmental situation that it couldn't sustain because of the business policies.
Right, ma'am.
But in banking, what is most important is safety of my money. And that, as a customer, I will never be able to find out how safe is my money in, say, Bank of Maharashtra. I rely on the bank. Same is the case with the healthcare setting. How safe was your transaction or your operation? You will never be able to find out. Right? You rely absolutely on the service provider. in any case, still in your lifetime, at times people are not able to find out what exactly happened to them when they were being operated. In many cases, you might have seen that when women deliver babies, some of them get infected with HIV. So they will never be able, unless it is till the time it is detected, even when it is detected, they will not be able to find out that they got it from the hospital. So when a consumer is looking at a service, there are some components he absolutely is relying on you. That is where ethics comes in. Right? Say, when I am teaching you, if I teach you something wrong, will you be, most of you probably will never be able to find out. But that is what is very important, is how credible is my service delivery. So those attributes also I have to take care when I am advertising. I should be emphasizing on the implicit attributes also. So that is the difference between an explicit and an implicit attribute. That explicit you will be able to find out by looking at things from your experience. Implicit, maybe over a lifetime, your lifetime you will not be able to find. But definitely it impacts the credibility of the service. And a single negative publicity about implicit can kill your entire service, your entire brand. So to that extent, implicit attributes are important. The last component that is not there in the slide is information. So information also is an important component. Information is how credible is the information that I am sharing with my customers or my stakeholders. So that is about transparency of the processes. So all good organizations have very updated brochures. They have updated websites. Their customers are exactly aware about what to say. So all information that you have, that you're sharing with your stakeholders, has to be transparent and updated. Say all hospitals will have to display the rate card. So of different kind of rooms that are available. So that the sharing of information comes in the information part. So is it clear? On this portion, anybody, any question?
No, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, I have a question.
No, ma'am.
Yeah, please ask. Please ask.
Ma'am, the implicit component, like you mentioned credibility, but it's acquired over a period of a time. So
yes, it
can be like measured in terms, for example, any hospital. The credibility is acquired over a period of time. They gain the confidence from the people. So, like, can it be measured or something like that?
Yeah, it can be. It can, you can measure these components on a Likert scale. The measurement in case of services, say if you're trying to measure quality, right? So quality in case of services, how do you measure? You will have to use a surrogate measure, that is customer satisfaction. You will have to use a Likert scale. Try to understand in service, there is this issue that maybe it may happen that a particular person is, or a particular teacher is not teaching up to the mark. But still the students may feel that the teaching was excellent. So that is why when we talk about quality, it is often perceived quality that is very important, that how your customer perceives you. It may or may not match with reality. So quality in case of service is a mental attitude. Attitudes you have to measure on a Likert scale. So you will have to use a Likert scale. And that way, all attributes you can measure. Likert scale is, you understand what's a Likert scale? Very good to good, very good to bad. So excellent.
Yes, type of rating scale.
Yes, a kind of a rating scale. So it is possible, but that is perceived again, may not match with reality. There could be a gap. And what is that gap? Nobody will ever be able to find out. So that's why I repeat and again repeat that ethics is so important in services. You have to be so careful about your ethical orientation. Otherwise, it may happen you are cheating your customers and your customers may never be able to find out. And that is so unfortunate. That doesn't mean that I do it. I know you will never be able to find out if I teach you wrong stuff. But should I be doing it? No. So your ethical orientation as a service provider has to be very, very strong, because many components are implicit. So what five components we have studied? Are they clear to all? Any other question? Questions are welcome.
I have a question, ma'am.
Yes.
This slide is termed as service package with a gamut of service components. But is it always necessary that a service has all of these components, or it depends on the business completely? Like a service with an IT product, should the facilitating goods components be a part of it? Or if it does...
I will like to clarify that. Earlier in the portion, you had a chapter on classification of services. Just like products are so easy to comprehend, services can be of several types. Almost in some books, old and new, if you put together types of services, there are 100 types. Right? So depending on certain important characteristics, services could be of different. Accordingly, the composition of these attributes, that's a good question, will vary. In some cases, you will see that facilitating goods are a very important component, say a QSR. Say a QSR like a MACD, a quick service restaurant. Lot of it is like a product, right? But in some other cases, like say pure teaching, it is mostly only a service. So in that case, the goods component, the facilitating goods, would be very less. So depending upon, and in some cases, information could be most important. Say online service. Right, say online teaching material, or say something that is happening, transaction is happening online. So information would be very important as compared to others. So that's a good question. Depending upon what type of service you are dealing with, I think I will be having that slide. I would have given it to you. Classification of services, but definitely it is there in the handout material that I have given.
Okay, ma'am.
It may not be there. It is there in my PC, but unfortunately, I cannot access. So there could be several types of services. Depending upon which type of service yours is, you will have a different composition of these five elements. So that is good. A good question. Any other? So can we have an assignment? How do we plan to have assignments? You let me know. So here we usually have an assignment wherein some groups are made, and for any particular service, eight components students identify. So can you also do, I will talk to Adnan and then we will work out something.
All right.
So is it understood by all?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
So we will proceed with the next slide. And that is, definition part we have covered, Indian scenario. So please read, update it. Some figures here and there would have changed. Now, because of this COVID-19, a lot of things would have changed. A lot of production-wise, we have gone down. A lot of challenges and struggles. So, but that's an exceptional situation. So, a lot of things about Indian scenario you should be aware. Why services are growing so much? Services sector comes in as which sector? Primary, secondary, or tertiary?
Tertiary.
Yes. So very good, it's a tertiary sector. Tertiary sector, the characteristics are that the productivity is very high. So a single person could be producing a lot. So few people are working, the output is huge. That's the typical service kind of a setup. Everywhere in case of services in India, if the sector is doing very good, exports are good, providing employment to a large base, growth also is high. So overall, quite a positive scenario in the GDP contribution of services is more than 50%. So that way you prepare your own slides on. And services are growing. Why? Because people have more disposable income. Nowadays, so many people are eating out. So QSRs the number is increasing and so on. So more disposable income, lesser time in hand, more dependence on other services make service sector a very lucrative sector. So this we have covered, plus we have covered different components of a typical service. Five components I will repeat. First is supporting facility, then the goods that are consumed, implicit, explicit, and information. So facilitating goods, supporting facility, implicit, explicit service. And lastly, we had the information that a service setting is providing. So is it under? So first characteristic then we will start, and that is intangibility. So services are intangible, means what now? Can you explain?
Means you can't touch it.
Services are performed rather than object. They can't be touched and seen.
You can only feel it. It's like an experience.
Yeah.
Yes. So services like can only be felt. Yes.
Yes.
So you can only experience services, and most of the time the tangible component could be very less. Mm-hmm. Another important thing about services is that services are co-produced. Co-produced means that unless the consumer participate, the delivery will not happen. Ma'am, but tangibility, first we will stick to only yes. Yes.
Ma'am, our video may stop after 40 minutes. So if it does, then I did one video and then you all can all join the meeting. Is it clear to everyone?
So after you have put a timer?
No, ma'am. I've not put a timer. It's a timer from the product itself, from the software. After 40 minutes.
Uh-huh. Okay, okay.
So I'll just create one more.
That's perfect. So we will take one more slide and we will stop so that you have a break and then you can join Pahuka, sir.
All right, because it's only 20 seconds remaining. That's why.
It's only 20 seconds?
Yeah, because we
are. Okay, then.
Oh.
So I will also put my slides in order. I'm missing out some slides.
Okay.
But till here it is, then when do we meet next? Will you tell me?
Yes, ma'am, I'll let you know.
Till here, you all be prepared. So next time when we start, let us keep at least 30 minutes. Any feedback from the session, audibility, voice clarity, please let me know.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, it's going on. Yeah. I can continue now because it didn't stop after 40 minutes. So we can continue mostly.
So we will continue till whatever time we can.
Ma'am, we'll continue.
So intangibility is one of the most important characteristic of services. And intangibility means that most of the time services can only be experienced. Now, what do you think are challenges because of intangibility? Say you are dealing with a service that is very intangible, right? Say you are probably dealing with an educational institute. You have started with your own. So what challenges will you face?
Ma'am, we'll have to be.
You can never truly estimate the true value of any intangible asset, I guess.
We can't know the quality unless we have experienced it.
I believe, ma'am, we'll have to be real.
Yes.
What we do. Because even if slight mistakes, right, the customer will identify, and as you said, that they'll go outside and even one bad mouth about services, then that will put the entire name bad. So we have to be really good at what we do. If it's really intangible.
We have to be really good. Yes. From customer's perspective, what are the challenges when they are looking at choosing or dealing with something so intangible? So just imagine that your very near and dear one has to get operated, right? A very high involvement and a high risk perception is there. Where most of the time service delivery is only a one-time event. The operation goes wrong, you may lose the life. It can never be undone. So to that extent, in case of a service, the customer's risk perception and involvement is high. So from his side, when he has to choose amongst the intangibles, what could be the challenges?
Trust.
So what's the challenge for a customer? Do you think his stress level would be high when he is buying a service as compared to a product? Yes.
Yes.
It is very difficult to judge the quality, as somebody said. So when a customer is buying a product, buying a service, the risk perception is high, involvement level is high, because he cannot sample. So I have to buy a house, say. Can I sample that this is how my house is going to look like?
Yes.
No. Exactly how it is going to look like, I really don't know. I have to first pay and then I will get the house. Hmm. When you took admission into Pumba, just imagine, did you ever think that something like COVID-19 would happen?
No.
So, and wo to theek hai. Did you experience Pumba's teaching before you took admission?
No.
So sampling a service, it is very difficult to sample. So you will have absolutely no idea how the final outcome will look like. Say somebody has to get operated, they have little idea what is going to happen, and finally will they get well or will they not get well. So is it clear? First thing is that customer risk perception involvement is very high. Sampling of a service is not possible. Then somebody very rightly said that quality is very difficult to judge. So are we still there or you are?
Ma'am, I have a question.
Yes.
When you said sampling is not possible, and for some services, I agree to it. But yes. An OTT platform like Netflix or Prime or yes. YouTube, Pulsar, they give the first month free without any commitment to the site.
Yes.
Isn't that a type of sampling of service that they provide?
This is one way in which we are easing the stress of the customer. So because of this challenge, different services have tried to look at and deal with this particular challenge. Say, one way that Netflix can do, but exactly at the time of delivery, what will happen, nobody knows. So first you will have to pay, and then the production of the service for you will start. Say I have to buy a house. Now there are some builders who give you a 3D view of the house. So that these days a 5D, 7D view also is available. So that is one way in which the customer's tension is they are trying to ease. But still, how my house is exactly going to look like, I will not know. Compare this to a product. You can look at the sunset bottle and do everything and then you buy it. So you know a lot about what is going to be there in the bottle.
Ma'am, wouldn't...
So you are buying it because you first look at it, the product is in your hand, and then you pay the money. Here what happens is first you pay the money. Say Pumba fees, you paid the fees. And then the delivery for you started, and still there is no option to get out of it even if you are not happy or satisfied.
Ma'am, but in the for real estate, as you were giving an example of a house, can't we like feel the product? Is it a product? Because it's more of a product than a service, right?
Again, I will again give you one more definition. That's a good question. That how do we differentiate between a product and a service? So in many cases, you will see why doesn't MACD become a product? Most of it is like a factory. Why is it called as a service? Why are all fast food outlets categorized into services? So somebody has given a good definition that he says that we are going to look at the cost. If the most of the cost is coming from the intangible, then the offering becomes a service. If most of the cost is coming from tangible, the offering becomes a product. So the line between a product and service is vanishing. It's becoming very thin because of different components that are being added to it. So how real estate falls into this is probably the component of the labor component. All intangibles are adding a lot to the cost part of it. So it becomes a service. Otherwise, if you look at a MACD service, a QSR like a MACD, it is production line manufacturing. Not many of service components are there, but still it is a service because in the cost, most of it is coming from the intangible. So that is why it is there. But it is works more or less because it is so standardized, little customization, little training. More or less, the whole offering is like a product. So what we will do, you take some time. Which books are you reading?
Okay. Philip Kotler.
No, don't read Philip Kotler. It has only one chapter. Don't read. Online, you will be able to identify out some books, good books. And material that I have given you, you begin to go through. And I think tomorrow we will not have. Day after, we will again meet. So once your base is ready, you have understood a typical nature of a service, then in one go, I will cover all characteristics. Or three characteristics, one we will leave. So three characteristics I will cover straight away in the next class. Is it fine with all? So you take time, you read. We will have some doubt, clarification, and then we will proceed.
Okay. Can you suggest some books for reading?
Books, which ones now? The library is not accessible.
We'll try to find it online.
Jha is a good book. Bhattacharya is a good book. Pizimon is the best book. It is the content is heavy. The book is on services management. It is not on services marketing. So I always suggest that if you want to really read services, read something on, read on services management and not only marketing. Services is a mixture of HR, marketing and operations. So operations guy or people who are good in quantitative would be very comfortable and they will enjoy reading Fitzsimmons. Most of the PPTs are available online. Please read. It's an excellent book with excellent material. All topics PPTs are available online.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
So that is one book. So we will meet again. And day after, we will schedule some. Okay, then. See you.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, take care. Okay, bye. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Bye, bye. Arda tasas lecture zalo.
Bharpur zalo na bhau. Chalo ajun thamba zara.
Madam join yaro. Chill.
Okay.
बोला था क्या बोले थे
पावर का सर ना इकडेच ऍड करू शकतो का आपण ते
इथेच ऍड करतो
हां पावर का सर ना इकडेच ऍड करा ना मग ते पण लेक्चर होऊन जाईल सर
हेलो अदनान कैन यू प्लीज ऍड पावरकर सर टू दिस मीटिंग ओनली
नो सबका ऐसे ही करो यार सर द
रिमोट का ऑन व्हाट्सएप आई थिंक सो गाइस
राइट मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स आर अवेलेबल इन दिस मीटिंग सो जस्ट ऐड हिम
सागर आई थिंक सो टाइम संपत असेल या सेशनचा आपण न्यू सेशन करावंच लागेल
नो नो तो न्यू सेशन सर ऑलरेडी
तोपर्यंत त्याला बोलू दे सरांबरोबर एकदा सर हो म्हणला की मग तो नवीन नवीन मीटिंग क्रिएट करेल लिंक पाठवेल आपण जॉईन करू
मला पॉपअप आला होता की अनलिमिटेड मिनिट्स ऍक्सेस बाय होस्ट म्हणून माझ्या मध्ये बंद नाही होणार बंद नाही होणार
सेशन सेशन बंद नाही होणार आहे कारण की 40 मिनिट्स टाइम नाही होता पण 40 मिनिट्स क्रॉस
ठीक मग अरे पाऊल करला लिंक पाठवा ना
सर
ते मेसेज वर काय ते म्हणायला लागले
लिंक पासवर्ड
मीटिंग का लिंक भेज दे सर
ते व्हाट्सअप वर काय ते करत होता
आय थिंक ही हॅड अ वर्ड विथ पावरकर सर आय डोंट नो
Sir will not be able
Manus?
To take the video on the video.
Manus? Huh? Sir, I guess too much of English is coming from out from your mouth, bro.
Sir, ne pehle hi bola ki sir le nahi payega aaj ka lecture. Audio pe, sir WhatsApp pe hi lenge.
What's up? Okay.
Theek hai, chalo.
Chalo,
okay. Chalega, theek hai, okay. Yeah.
Bye-bye, guys.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Anup. Be safe.